have got WhatsApp on my iPad. If I tap on WhatsApp for iPad, here I have got all the WhatsApp messages loaded on this iPad. So how do you use WhatsApp on iPad? That's something you are going to learn in this video. Hello everyone, Rahul here from TechReviewPro and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to learn how to get WhatsApp messages on iPad. As you can see, I'm getting WhatsApp messages on my iPad without installing WhatsApp. And this is an old iPad, but even if you have got any old iPad or new iPad, this method will work on every iPad. So make sure you watch this video until the end. Now, without any further delay, let's learn how to get WhatsApp messages on iPad without installing WhatsApp. So if you go to App Store and search for WhatsApp, that's what basically everyone does if they are going to use WhatsApp on iPad. You will see various WhatsApp apps available here, and these are basically third-party WhatsApp clients which usually promise you to help you be able to use WhatsApp on iPad. But if we go here, let's say this one, and if we scroll a bit here, you can see in reviews that after paying $2,700 for lifetime subscription, it only works once in a week. And that's pathetic. Most of these apps are made for the purpose of minting money from users like you. And if you are not aware, you will end up buying their in-app purchases to remove ads and pay money only, and without being able to use WhatsApp on iPad, because WhatsApp app on iPad doesn't exist. But there is a way to use WhatsApp on iPad, and for that you need to keep watching. Let's learn. As you might already be knowing, WhatsApp allows you to use WhatsApp in a browser using WhatsApp Wave feature, and using that feature only you can use WhatsApp on iPad. Let me show you how. All you have to do is you have to go to any web browser, let's say Safari, and here you have to type web.whatsapp.com, and once typed, hit go or enter, and this will load a QR code for you to scan from your WhatsApp. So if you have WhatsApp already logged into your phone, you simply need to go to WhatsApp on your phone, and here you need to go to linked device under settings. Here you get the option to link device. Tap on this and this will start scanning. And once scanned, this will start logging in. As you can see, this is logging, and then your messages will start loading in the WhatsApp Wave for browser. And by the way, if you want, I can also show you by sending a test message here. Let me show you that. As you can see, I just sent this message, and this message is coming on this WhatsApp on iPad. So this is how I'm using WhatsApp on my iPad. But obviously this has some minor issues as well. Like, you need to enter a web.whatsapp.com in the browser URL tab every time you need to use WhatsApp on iPad. But there's a workaround, and you can fix that issue, and I'll let you know that as well. So keep watching. All you have to do is you have to tap on this share icon, and once you tap on that, you need to scroll a bit, and here you get the option to add to home screen. So tap on that, and here you enter any name like WhatsApp Wave for iPad, and then tap add. And this will add WhatsApp Wave to your home screen so that you may easily use it again in just one tap, like this. Another issue is the notifications don't come unless or until you keep the browser active or refresh the browser tab. But that's the way it is, and we can't do anything about it unless Apple or WhatsApp does. So that's pretty much for this video. And this is how I'm using WhatsApp on my iPad. By the way, if you want to learn how to change App Store country region on your iPad, make sure you tap here to watch this video.